This is WGN Television, Channel 9, Chicago's own television station.
WLS plays more.
Richard Speck is sought tonight for the murder of those 8 student nurses in Chicago. Reports of his whereabouts have cropped up all the way from Illinois to Texas, where he's known to have relatives. Speck looks like the man. He fits the description given police by a lone survivor, and his fingerprints have been found in the apartment where the girls were killed. Speck's brother Howard says the news of the hunt for Richard has left him and his wife nervous wrecks, but he says he'll turn Richard in if he shows in Monmouth, Illinois. The object of the police hunt is 25. He has a record, is known as a seaman, a kind of jack-of-all-trades, and he's liberally adorned with tattoos.
The murders shocked and horrified the entire city, resulting in one of the largest manhunts in the city of Chicago. For 2 days, the suspect, later identified as Richard Speck, eluded police by holding up in a seedy West Madison flophouse. Fearing that capture was imminent, Speck slashed his wrist and arm, allegedly attempting suicide. Police later discovered blood-stained papers and clothes in room 584 of the Star Hotel. Speck was taken to Cook County Hospital, where an alert doctor noticed the tattoo emblazoned on his arm that read, "Born to Raise Hell," a tattoo which had been described earlier to police by the only surviving nurse, Corazon Amaral. The morning after the murders, Amaral was able to tell police what the world would soon know.
When Chicagoans awoke that hot July morning, they received the horrible news that Richard Speck had killed 8 nurses in this apartment, taking them one by one from the bedroom, tying them with bed sheets, either strangling or stabbing them all. Only one nurse survived, Corazon Amaral. She hid under a bed and survived the entire ordeal. Later, to crawl out on this ledge and scream to the neighborhood, "They're all dead. All of my friends are dead. I'm the only one who's alive."
Without her identification and the description, chances are I will probably still be working on it.
Jack Walenda was the first detective on the scene after the murders were reported. Now retired, he still remembers the gruesome scene like it was yesterday.
It was a terrible scene. What made it so bad for me is that I knew 3 of the girls personally. And you walk in and you see something like this, it was a pretty good shock.
And what did you feel this morning when you heard the news that he had died?
Well, I was just happy that he's dead. Too bad the man didn't suffer more than he took the easy way out. But I think it's going to be a lot better for remaining members of the family so he don't have to suffer every year when that sucker came up for parole hearings.
The prosecutor, William Martin, called Speck a sociopath who killed without remorse.